Hall police addressed the ongoing search for a man who broke into a woman's home early Monday morning and raped and robbed her. At their monthly community meeting, the police say the case is the first thing they addressed, calling it a priority and emphasizing how rare this type of case is. Jennifer Hoff reports on what the department is doing to find the man.
Quiet St. Paul community left feeling unsettled tonight after police say a man broke into a home and sexually assaulted a woman in the McAllister Groveland neighborhood.
We are going to start out our meeting today a little bit different,
prompting a discussion at the city's monthly community meeting led by longtime Sergeant Mike Ernster.
It's also important for all of you to feel safe and secure in your homes and your neighborhoods.
Neighbors say they're still processing the attack that happened around 4:30 Monday morning, the victim asleep, when police say the armed suspect pounded on the door, forced his way inside, and also robbed her. Police setting up a perimeter using thermal drones and canines with its forensics unit to try and process any DNA.
There's only a couple other times that we do this, and those times are homicides. So that kind of gives you the level of priority that we put on this case.
Ernster says there have been 55 other criminal sexual conduct incidents this year, but none like this. National data shows sexual assaults by strangers are rare. In fact, 8 out of 10 rapes are committed by someone the victim knows.
We have not had anything like this in our city. There is no trend, there is no pattern, but it is disturbing and we have to hold him accountable.
So the suspect in this case is described as an African-American man between 25 and 35 years old, and there's this. He has a vertical scar going from his chest to his belt line, so that would certainly stand out. If you know anything, police say to give them a call. There's also another community meeting Thursday at McAllister College that's hosted by the Neighborhood Community Council for that neighborhood, where they say they'll also address what happened. Julie.
All right. Thank you, Jennifer.